This might explain some of the issues with Windows 11 22H2. We're talking about the power plants. Pay extra attention if you have an Intel 12th or 13th generation processor. Intel's 12th and 13th gen CPUs have performance cores for your apps or games and efficiency cores for background tasks and processes. We're going to run Latency Monitor CPU tab and Task Manager to track utilization between the two operating systems. If I look at the default balanced power plan from Windows 11 21H2 and compare it with Windows 11 22H2, do you see something different? Windows 11 22H2 has most of the CPU utilization on this Intel 13900K going to performance cores. Windows 11 21H2 is utilizing the CPU properly, apps running on performance cores, background tasks and drivers use efficiency cores. On the other hand, Windows 11 22H2 is running the processor like it has no efficiency cores. I struggled to understand the difference in the behavior at first. Then the solution came to me after looking at my own custom power plan. One specific power setting made a difference. It was the heterogeneous policy and effect setting. Notice Windows 11 22H2 has a different default value for balanced and high performance power plans. When the settings are changed to the numbers from Windows 11 21H2 from 0 to 4, the efficiency cores are being used again. Not only that, about 10 existing fields had their values changed and about 10 new fields were added as part of the power plan templates. Microsoft made changes to the default, high performance, and balanced power plans. The power saver plan only had the new fields added with no value changes to existing fields. Today, I'll share a few things that are in the video description. A side-by-side Excel comparison of the default Windows 11 21H2 and Windows 11 22H2 power plans exported from QuickCPU. Custom power plans are made based off Windows 11 21H2 for use in Windows 11 22H2, and a custom power plan I made for Intel's 12th and 13th gen processors. Here's how to import the power plans to Windows 11 22H2. Download the power plan zip file. Extract the power plans to a folder of your choice. Make sure you're logged in with admin rights on your PC and run the power plan batch file. Close the batch file. To use one of these three power plans, go to search and type power. Go to choose a power plan. You should now see the three additional power plans imported. You can try them out and see if one of these three plans would improve performance on your Windows 11 22H2 system. In the event you don't want the imported power plans, you can remove them. To do this, go to each power plan and choose Delete this plan. One last note. In QuickCPU, changing the heterogeneous policy and effect setting value to 1 seems to have an improvement with system responsiveness. Microsoft does not have any documentation posted for this specific section online, but if I'm looking at a surface level point of view, a value of 1 seems to apply a prefer performant cores setting. Efficiency cores also seem to be more responsive. For Windows 10 users, making the change to the heterogeneous policy does not make a difference. Windows 10 will treat all cores the same. That's it for today. Smash that thumbs up if this was informative or helped you. Support the channel with a super thanks and stay subscribed with notifications on. You can also follow me on social media at Dave Finito. Have a great rest of your day and I'll see you guys next time.